Hello everybody and welcome back to Chris the Bodger's channel. Today we're looking at super magnets, neodymium, dangerous and fun. What a wonderful combination! On an upcoming project, I need to drill a hole in one. Not with one of these, this is too big. We're going to try a tile bit, a carbide bit, because we know these things are very hard and have an outer shell of nickel to protect them from the elements. So we need to drill this nice and slowly, not create too much heat. I do believe if you go over the temperature of 80 degrees, it affects the alignment and it loses some magnetism. So we'll have to go very carefully. But we do have one problem. As the drill bit gets closer, the magnet is attracted to it. So we may need to attach this to a steel plate and a bath of water. So let's have a look. And there we go, one water bath. One steel plate. Now you have to be very careful when you put one of these magnets towards a piece of steel. It'll snap very, very strongly. It has to be eased on, and they're very brittle, they can shatter. So I'll try my best to be very careful. There we go. I'm going to set that up over the drill. One problem I can see is hopefully the bit won't slide around on top of the magnet. It may need a pair of pliers or grips to hold it in place as well, but we'll try first and see if we get on. Let's go over to the drilling machine. Before I've started, I've hit a problem. Refraction of the light. When I put the drill bit in, it looks like it's miles away from where it should be. The only solution is to drain a bit of the water away just to the top of the magnet so I can get a start. And once it's started, I can add more water. Before we start, I've decided to add a clamp. I suspect as soon as a drill bit touches the sphere, the whole thing would spin. It would kind of make sense. Let's begin. A good starting point, so we'll now add extra water to the bath. The secret to this is go nice and slowly. It probably doesn't make for a great video. As per normal, it's not going very well in Chris's shed. We're having alignment issues. Obviously, drilling a sphere is not as easy as a flat magnet or a cylinder. But this seems to be holding well, so we'll now continue. There we have it, it's done. That was relatively straightforward and easy. We have a lovely magnetic sludge. Magnetic sludge. Let's clean it up and take it to the bench. This stuff's very interesting. Good fun. We'll keep that. But first we release it from the clamp, which may be easier said than done. There we go. Just a matter of getting it out of there now. It's done. We've managed to drill a nice 6mm hole into the centre of the sphere magnet, the super magnet. These things are very brittle. But we've got no chipping. And we didn't overheat the magnet. It's still got, I'd say, at least 95% of its magnetism. One thing I did notice, so when I stick a piece of metal inside the hole, it's not as strong, the magnetic field. It says, but it's quite strong on the outside. When we put it inside, it's quite easy to remove, but it doesn't matter. I'm going to attach a brass rod with resin, or maybe a hook with resin, so we can hang it from a piece of string. Until then, I need to protect the hole. I'm going to put a piece of tape across it. These things oxidise in oxygen. So thank you everybody for viewing. And there's not much on the internet about this. So it's the first in Krista Bodge's shed. Please come back again and see what happens with the magnet. Magnet.